guys, sorry for the connection delay. My next guest is a friend of mine. You all know him very well. We've done this before in the past as well. The conversation this time around will more be focused on sport and mindset and what we think like. He's one of the leading scorers in the world of football, second only to Ronaldo. He's a goal machine, he's a captain of our football team. He's a leader, he's a living legend, and more importantly, a very close friend of mine. My next guest is Mr. Sunil Chhetri. I'm going to go ahead and join in through the view mind here. Hope it works. There he is.
Champ, how you doing, man?
How are you, Skip?
I'm good, man. I'm good. I was preparing for this, and you said we can't be goofy, yeah?
No, we can be. We can be in between, but it can't be like last time.
ये तो वही हो गया कि क्वेश्चन बिल्कुल कुछ और आ गया, पढ़ के कुछ और आया था.
No, it's great to have you here, Skip.
Thank you so much.
You know why we are here. We're all united in sport, and that's the most beautiful thing about sport. Regardless of what sport you play, you can literally have a conversation, discuss mindset, and the focus is very, very similar. I just had a chat with Pep, and it was amazing.
I saw that.
Get insights into his head, what he thinks like, and it's so reassuring to know that, you know, the mindset is so similar, be it any sport anywhere in the world. So yeah, that was quite cool, and now I'm very excited for our chat as well. You don't have to ask me any questions. Firstly, I want to clarify, this is all about me asking you questions. Okay, and similar to KL, Pep, yourself, and I'm gonna speak to one more guest. I won't reveal now. So the template is very simple. I ask you the questions, and then we discuss mindset, and I want to understand your point of view, your mindset.
Okay. Yes, sir.
So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to ask the first question. When the pandemic hit us, you knew things would not be the same. How has your preparation for this season's ISL, both from a physical as well as a mental space, has been so far?
I think when it started for the first 1 month, I had actually no clue as to what I'm going to do. Suddenly not being allowed to go out, not being allowed to train was difficult. And suddenly it hits you that probably life is much more bigger than your sport. कि आप बाहर जा रहे हो नहीं जा रहे हो आप ट्रेनिंग कर रहे हो नहीं कर रहे हो and then slowly and steadily you become positive and you make do whatever is there. I still remember, if I can say, I was talking to you and I was getting fat, and I don't know if you remember, you had already started your system, you already started your training, and that really hit me, that, you know, it's already been 1.5 months, better better kha raha hu se mota ho raha hu. And then I started with whatever was there at home. It started with being more disciplined. Training always comes naturally to us. I think the more difficult part is time pe sona aur dhang se khana. Wo aisi jagah hai jahan par I think we falter a lot, especially knowing ki abhi 6 mahine tak league shuru hoga nahi, that just rips in your head. So that was more difficult. And now thankfully we are allowed to train, of course, under bio bubble. It's very good to be back with the team. Individually we have all worked hard. It shows. A lot of the youngsters have come really ripped, really fit, which is really a welcome change. And now we'll get into the basic of getting fitter as a team and you know, understanding stuff. But I think yes, yeah, Virat, but I think mentally was the more difficult part, you know, just to be more patient, just to have your own system to make sure where you're going, to have a goal, to be more disciplined. That was more difficult.
Do you think that uncertainty that we all experienced is going to help you to bring in more acceptance of the outcome of the games or any situation in general going forward?
I hope so. In life particularly, game mein to hum waise hi rahenge yaar, jab kuch hota hai, jab kuch haarte hain to dimag kharab hota hai, chillate hain, cheekte hain. But I think in life generally, a lot of me has been more calmer. I think I've got a lot of gratitude towards life now. Not trying to be philosophical, but just seeing around so much, and you think that you are so, so gifted, you are so fortunate, it gives you a lot of gratitude. And yeah, that probably is the change. But as far as game is concerned, जब कोई मिस पास करेगा, जब कोई गोल मिस करेगा तब पास चलेगा, जब मैच हारेगा तब पास चलेगा. अरे वो नहीं जाएगा, वो अंदर से नहीं जाएगा, वो गुस्सा, वो चिल्लाना, वो नहीं जाएगा.
Cool, cool. Okay. My second question is around the learnings of sport. So sport teaches us many lessons: humility, teamwork, mental and physical strength, to name some of them. But can you share with us one lesson that you learned and the story behind it, if you have a story, something special that you learned through sport?
I think in my life I've learned more from defeats. I don't know if it makes sense, but whenever there has been a phase now where I've won a lot, in a period of time I've seen that I've become complacent because I'm winning. Because when you're winning, more or less you think everything is going well, so few things which you are doing right, you become complacent. Small examples, like, you know, something comes in my head is not eating right, or not going for recovery session, or not doing stretching after a session. All the small things. But then suddenly when the phase comes when you start losing, then you realize, oh,
yeah.
What about you?
Yeah, it makes sense. I know
I'm not allowed to ask questions. I know I'm not allowed to ask a question, but what about you? I know I'm not allowed to ask a question, but what about you?
No, I mean, over a period of time, what you're saying is absolutely right. You understand that you win more from, you learn more from losses, not victories. Because when you win, you hardly reflect on things. But what I have realized now is that actually you should reflect even when you win.
True.
True. That to me is probably something that, yeah, I try and focus on now. And something that, you know, you always have something that you can improve on, something that you can learn and get better at. So
True.
I think if we can get that sort of consistency in wins and losses, then I think you're going in the right direction and we can be more balanced moving forward. That to True. Me probably would be my learning.
True.
Interesting. I mean, I totally understand what you're saying, but, you know, this is all about people getting to know mindset and trying to apply that somewhere or the other in their lives, and that's the whole essence of talking mindset through sport. Okay, number three, it's actually I'm asking you this also to learn. I have never seen you lose your cool on the field. Even when you score a goal in the dying minutes, you are still very calm. How do you do it?
I think, first of all, I don't believe this, that that's true. I more than often keep my cool. But a lot of time, I lose my cool also. But I think over the period of time, I've realized ki usse kuch hoga nahi. So I try to keep my anger and I go one and one with the player or whatever inside the dressing room because he's more calmer. If I shout in between a game, even he wants to win. He's trying his best. But if I shout, I might lose it for the whole game. So I've realized this. I did a lot of mistakes. Because in my game, unlike cricket, you don't have that time where you can go and talk to the guy. Let's suppose a Chahal bowls a ball which you don't want him to bowl repeatedly. You can go to him, put your arm around and say, you know what, Chahal, this is not the field that we have set. Come on. But in my game, there is no time. So it's so sudden. It comes and you burst out and you scream. but then you lose him.
Yeah.
There's no time. And especially with the young ones, I've lost many young ones and I felt bad because I'm affecting their game. If I'm angry, I'm affecting my game also. So I try to keep all my anger and wait for the dressing room. I go there. If I'm really furious, I hold the collar, I take him to the bathroom. And we all find this. But I've lost my cool a lot of times, by now I think probably I'm a cooler, but before I've lost my cool a lot of times.
I think that's the reason why a lot of people, as you just rightly pointed out, might not react very well to that kind of response. So it's always better to understand them and just have a chat at close quarters. That's a great lesson for all of us, including myself, all of us who compete in sport. I think we all can take a lot of learning from that. So thank you. Okay, in the past, you have asked fans to come to the stadium and cheer. I know I was part of that request as well. How would you ask the fans to show their support this time around where they're not allowed to come to the stadium? So what would you or your message be for the fans to still be engaged, still back the team? How do you think that can be achieved?
So I think I can say as a fan, when we got the news that we're not allowed to go and watch in the stadiums, as a fan, you always feel bad. And so did I. I thought, you know what, football or any sport is all about fans. You know, you have a jam-packed stadium, you feel the buzz, and that's what you want to do. But then I watched a game, I think it was Schalke Dortmund, one of the first games which was allowed. And I realized live sports gives you so much happiness. Of course, it's not as compared to what you can get when you go to the stadiums, but it's equally exciting. So whenever you get an opportunity to watch live sports, there isn't many things in life which is better than that.
Yeah.
And I'm saying it with all my heart because you know it. I watch your matches live. You know, a game that I'm still trying to understand. But it's so exciting.
Yeah.
You know, every live sport teaches so much and it's so exciting. So no matter what sport you like, if you're not allowed to go to the stadium right now, for a very understandable reason, watch in telly. You know, it's so much fun because it's live. You can't replicate it. You can watch anything you want.
Yeah.
But if there's something live sport, you can't replicate it. So as a fan, you got to be patient till the time we get over this. But till the time, watch on television, whichever sport you like, watch it and enjoy it.
Yeah, I totally agree with you. And one interesting thing to know is that when fans come to the stadium, obviously they come to watch and they come to enjoy. But I feel that the players benefit more from fans being there.
Yeah.
But fans, even from watching at home, if you put your full energy into watching, like, you know, supporting the team, it reaches the team somehow. Like, that support reaches. So I think all the fans all around the world can even watch at home. Just purely, genuinely being committed to watching the team that you play for in ISL or whether it's Team India, they genuinely want to see your team win. That energy definitely reaches the team somehow. I don't know how, but it somehow reaches and the players can suddenly feel it. You know, suddenly they'll get a boost. So I'm sure the fans are going to be tuned in. And the fans are going to be tuned in big time. Okay, so this one is quite a cool question. You're now the second highest international goal scorer among the active players in the world with only Ronaldo ahead of you. How do you feel about this achievement and what keeps you going even after so many years? What's the essence?
Yeah, champ, if I have to be honest, I listen to this comparison for like 5 seconds. I feel happy and then I forget about it because there is no comparison. I know it.
No,
you know it. I know.
It's not a comparison, but look, the thing of pride for all of us is that I know I have seen the graph of Indian football as well. I know the league coinciding is a huge factor, but you need to have leadership. You need to have a guy who's willing to say, look, I want to take Indian football to places. And you have been that guy who's never, ever let go of that vision. So when we say these things, we say it out of a lot of pride and a lot of love for what you have done and what you continue to do. There are not many people who you can see and say, this guy is going to take the team forward. And we can look at you and say, this guy is taking the team in the right direction.
Thank
so that's what I want to understand, that what keeps you going as a leader, taking the team forward, year after year and just giving everything that you have? What is the essence?
First of all, thank you for the lovely words, champ. I think the joy that I get of playing football and the love that I get all around, it's unbelievable. It's something that I'd never dreamt of even. So now when I'm there, where everybody has an expectation, where everybody wants me to do well, including my own teammates and people, it's just such a feeling that I want to give everything that I've got. And that's what I do. I generally don't take, the way you said, I don't take that much of pressure, because if I think like that, then I'm the one and I have to do this and I've got this many goals, then I'll succumb to pressure. I just enjoy it because I'm living a life which I had never even dreamt of. Where I am and what I can do for myself, for my family, for the country, is unbelievable. I couldn't have ever dreamt of. I mean, I'm sure you feel the same way. Where we are right now, this is extraordinary, man, for both of us from where we have come to get this platform and opportunity. Absolutely. The only thing that I do is I don't let even a day go by that I don't give my 100%. So whatever time left, I make sure that I'm mad at it, because there's very few years left. This is a place where everybody wants to be. I am where everyone wants to be. Yeah. And I'm the only one who's chosen one. So I enjoy it and I give everything that I've got. I mean, I don't take too much pressure on that.
That's amazing to know. That's you're very grateful for where you are, and that's the only way you can be absolutely committed, because you never worked for incentives, you never worked for a goal that you have achieved and you're like, okay, I'm done. You totally started for the love of it, and that love continues. And when you know that you don't feel as passionate about it, that's when you know that it's time to pass on the baton to the next guy. So
That's a good point you say. When you if you're chasing some goal, and you might get satisfied. So for me, I always keep it that I'm loving this game. No matter what I achieve, no matter how many games I lose or win, one day it'll end. So rather talk about them there. So once we finish, whenever it is, then we can talk. Arey, usme ye hua tha, usme ye kya tha, usme itna kharaab khela, usme itna chak mila. But for now, I'm just enjoying it, man. It's a lovely place to be in.
That's amazing, Binoskip. I hope that you keep going.
Thank you.
I don't know, forever, because you look like you can go on forever, unless you start eating chole bhature.
By the way, we had this cheat meal, and I had like 3 days back, I had 5 parathas, full ones, and Gurpreet Singh Sandhu had 14 parathas, broke all records.
14?
He will kill me for doing this. He'll kill me for doing this.
If I do that now, like today, now, we have a game tomorrow. I'll be different tomorrow, like that quickly. I'll be fat tomorrow, I promise you.
No, but I think he's super fit, but he can do it.
Okay, next question is a very sweet one. You've been married to Sonam since 2017. And she's a lovely girl. Me and Anushka both, we came home and it was so nice the way you guys hosted us, and we had a really amazing evening together. My question is, if I gave you an option to play a sport with Sonam as your partner, which sport would it be and why?
Ooh, that's a difficult one. I think I'll go for a relay run with her.
Okay.
Or I'll do like relay race where there are four people. Why? She's good, man. She runs well, man. Or I will do weightlifting with her.
Okay.
She will shock you, man. She is unbelievable. I know, I mean, she's my wife, so I'm saying it, but she's unbelievable in the gym. She surprises me with the kind of weight she can pick. Also scares me that I can't go in a physical fight with her. Also scares me, but she's unbelievable, man. She's unbelievable.
That's so cool. So, okay, I'll take relay race, because that's more of a partnership, running around and then passing quite cool. Maybe someday we can all go to the track and run. Okay, my last question to you is, I know for a fact that you love the game of cricket. Hope you enjoyed the new Puma boots I sent across, and when can we have a cricket match and a football game together?
Mahaprabhu, main to aapko kab se request kar raha hu ki mujhe khelna hai. I went 1 month to play cricket every day, and I have a funny anecdote for you.
Yeah.
There was I played with under 19 boys there in Bangalore.
Yeah,
Yeah, and there's a game called 2-day game. I never knew about it. So there's 2-day game where one team plays 90 overs and 90 overs. So I 90 over fielding ki pareshan ho gaya because you're fielding, suddenly a ball will come and you'll miss a catch, and I missed a catch also. And the next day I went to bat and I was out in 20 minutes. And I was like, oh, what has happened? But on a serious note, this 30 days of training cricket, I understood, it is so difficult. You know, you have some notion of a game in your mind, but when you play it, you understand. It is so, the concentration that has to be there is, but I enjoyed it. So, I'm telling you, I'm going to do an exhibition match. I'm a good wicketkeeper, by the way. I'm just putting on this forward. Yeah.
Okay, cool. So, I'll organize that. And we'll bat together. We'll bat and we'll run together as well. It'll be quite cool.
Yeah, running I can do. I can do. We keep the strike, I'll run. Going.
Yeah, we'll scare a few fielders. Cool. Thanks, Skip. Thanks for taking out the time.
Thanks, champ. Before I go, I have to ask you something, champ. Okay, just one. On. You asked me not to ask one. First of all, congratulations on whatever's happening between you and Anushka. We are so happy. I'm sure the whole country is happy.
Thank you.
I hope she's healthy, happy and enjoying.
She is, yes.
I just want to ask you one thing. Who is more nervous before a big game, you or before a big release, her? Who becomes more anxious or you know, jittery? Who is the one?
You know, to be honest, it's not. I think there's more on the line before a big release because it happens over a period of time. So yeah. In sport, you know that we can have a game today and after 2 days we can have another game and you can change the result.
True. Right,
when you play well. But a movie is hard work of 4, 5, 6 months and then you have that one day when the Friday release happens. So you can imagine the kind of anticipation, nervousness, pressure one feels. So I think from a very logical point of view, it's way more before a big release. And it totally makes sense because if you have an opportunity to put something out in front of the public after that much time of hard work,
true,
you're always going to feel like what might happen, what might not happen. So the two cannot be compared. With sport, as I said, you feel nervous, but the magnitude of the nerves you feel before a big release are not comparable because it's so... you know, placed accordingly that you work hard for so long and then one day, and then you're judged on that one day. It's quite harsh as well, but yeah, that's way more nerve-wracking, I would say, than what we feel before a big game.
All right. So before I let you go, one more question, because I have to ask you this. So imagine if you only have 30 minutes and you could pick one batting session or a fielding session or any other workout. There is no situation of having a match tomorrow, what is a normal day, but you only have 30 minutes to pick one training session. Either it can be a batting session or a fielding or any other workout. What would you choose and why?
I will choose weights. I will choose Olympic lifting. 30-minute session, snatch, cleans, overhead squats, split jerk. I will just do that for 30 minutes. Do a proper workout, and I will choose that any day.
Wow, that's a good one. But I think that's also do you think it's also because you already back yourself in batting and fielding and you know that once you're fitter, you'll do better than both the department?
Yeah, I think we end up paying too much attention to skill at times and we neglect fitness. But if your fitness is not up there, then the skill is of no use.
True.
Because in important skill will not bail you out all the time. It's your desire and the desire should be backed by your fitness.
True.
Because if your body doesn't support what you want to do on the field, it's of no use. And in that important moment for the team in a big game, if you don't take that brilliant catch, if you don't stop that one run, if you don't effect that brilliant run out, or you can't run in between the wickets, then the team loses.
True.
So, you know, So when you understand the importance of these small moments over a period of time, you figure out that fitness is far more important for longevity and
Yeah.
even those important moments.
Well said, dost. So all the best for tomorrow's match.
Thanks, Kate.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Thanks a lot, man. Lovely talking
all
to you
guys.
All the
best for your preparation.
Thank you
your
so much.
Upcoming season is. Thank you so much for taking
we'll
your
do a
time.
goof, we'll do a
I
goofy
hope
one.
to speak to you tomorrow.
Yeah, we'll do a goofy one soon.
We'll do a goofy one again, for sure.
Cheers, Sam. Take care.
Okay, done, Skip. Thank you very much.
Bye-bye.
Cheers, take care. Bye-bye.